Hello there! Welcome to this video! Let's see together how to work properly using layout inside SketchUp Pro 2015. Leave us comments to improve our future videos. Layout is a subcomponent inside SketchUp that is used to edit previews or create 2D projects, complete with measurements and distances. When you open layout, you must choose a paper template, such as its correct size and aspect ratio. At this point, you can start drawing a 2D project, which can be, for example, an object schematic or a building floor map. You can use the first set of tools to draw lines, arcs, circles, and polygons. Layout helps you while drawing through snappings and dashed lines, indicating parallel directions to X and Y axes. If you want to disable snappings, just go to Arrange on top and set on or off Object and Grid Snap at the bottom. Closed path and polygons are always filled up. Use Escape key to finish drawing while using Lines tool. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. You can edit each object easily with the Select tool enabled. You can click and drag to move. Drag from the blue arrows to scale. If you hover the small blue node on the center, and then click, you rotate the object. You can also edit more objects at the same time. With the Select tool enabled, click and drag and include in your selection area all objects interested. In this way, any editing applied will affect all objects inside. You also have other edit tools on top. Use Erase to delete objects. If you mistake, use Ctrl and Z to undo. SketchUp groups all together lines that lead to create a polygon. If you want to work with its single sides, you need to separate them from the shape. You can do so using the Split tool. Just click on two nodes to ungroup such side from your polygon. If you want to group the side again, use the Join tool. Simply enable it and click on the side and on the object that the side has to belong to. You can also add text to your 2D project. Just go to the Text tool and then click on a point to start typing. When you finish, click elsewhere with your pointer. Pieces of text are included inside the text box, which is highlighted in blue, and can be moved dragging it as seen before, using the Select tool. Make sure not to make the box too much small, or just part of the text will be visible. In this case, a red down arrow will appear. If you want to edit text again, simply double-click inside the box. You can edit objects and text carefully using the panels on the right. Select the object to edit and change its style on Shape Style. You can change the fill color, the stroke color and thickness, and any line style. You can fill with patterns, going to Pattern Fill and selecting one. If you select a text and you use Shape Style, you will add stroke and fill to the text box. To edit text, you need to go to Text Style more below. If you have a part of the text selected, just this will be affected by your changes. Very important are the measurements and labels you can trace on your project. Use the label tool to add arrows and notes to your project. Just click, drag, and then type. You can use dimensions to add measurements. Just define the site to measure first, and then set the correct distance from it. If you don't like the measurement unit or style, just select it and edit it through dimension style. Layout isn't just this. You can also import a SketchUp project and work with it on the background. You can browse and import a SketchUp project, going to File and then to Insert. A SketchUp project is shown with all its objects and environment inside, but without its Cartesian axis. This can be moved, scaled, and rotated like a normal object, but not edited inside. In this case, you need to use the main SketchUp software. Just right-click on the project and go to Open with SketchUp. You can still change point of view. Just right-click on the project and go to Edit 3D View to use the Orbit tool inside. When you finish, click Elsewhere. Keep in mind that the orbit affects just the objects inside your project, not anything added or created through layout. You may have objects overlapping. To decide which objects must be on others, right-click on the objects and go to Arrange. You can cut, copy, paste, or flip objects, simply right-clicking on them. When you have finished, you can save and export your project. If you go to File and then to Save, you will save a layout project that can be opened again later to edit it. But if you need to export your project, for example to print it, go to File and then to Export. All your objects will be saved, regardless of what you are actually seeing on your workspace. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our guide for more about SketchUp Pro 2015.